How do robots navigate without tracks, tags or GPS? It's about how arculus figure out exactly where they are on their own.
This is arcTech. I'm Dennis Schradig, Robotics Software Engineer at arculus.
From QR markers to free navigation.
Free navigation is what we call at arculus, the technology that allows our arculi to localize and navigate itself in basically any environment. In previous versions of our robot, what we did was using visual landmarks, so-called QR markers, that we would detect on the warehouse floor. Those have the disadvantage that they're time and cost intensive installation, maintenance and calibration procedures. So now with free navigation, what we want to do is use what's already there, and that both in terms of the sensor setup of the robot as well as the environment that we operate in.
How does the robot actually know where it is? What sensors are used?
The way the state estimation of our robot works is to utilize two basic types of sensors. So we have the relative sensors and the absolute sensors, basically. So what a relative sensor is, it could be like an inertial measurement unit that measures the rotational velocity and the acceleration of the robot, as well as sensors like wheel sensors that understand how fast the wheels are turning, and therefore we can deduce how the robot is moving. So basically we integrate these quantities mathematically to derive the position and orientation of the robot. But this technique has one disadvantage, because like if we have noise or problems like wheel slip, then we can kind of like lose where we are. So what's usually used is an absolute reference of the environment to know where we are within the operating space. And like I said before, we were using these QR code markers, and now the great thing is we're using laser scanners. And these laser scanners are already mounted on the arculi because they're very essential for the safety layer of our robots to allow for human safe operation. And now additionally, we're using those to understand where we are in the world to have accurate and efficient localization.
So how do arculis localize without QR codes, even over long distances?
The short answer to that is we're using an absolute reference to the world using the laser scanners. To go a bit deeper, what we basically do is we try to understand where we are in the environment by matching what we see with the laser scanners to a pre-generated map of the environment. So, and this map is also generated using the laser scanners with a technique called simultaneous localization mapping, short SLAM, that basically understands the world and models it in kind of a grid representation where each cell of the grid is either free or occupied with something like a wall or a pillar or any kind of obstacle that is static in the environment. Then when we drive through the environment with the robot, we create these snapshots of the worlds with the laser scanner and then match all the points that we find with the previously generated map. We can then say, okay, this is where we probably are within the world. And then combining them with the relative measurements of the other sensors that I mentioned before, we can say accurately where we are positioned and oriented in the world.
And what about when high precision is needed, like docking?
These high accuracy situations are very crucial for the operation of our robot. And the way we tackle them is that we kind of switch to a different mode of localization. We localize the robot relative to these stations or objects in general. You could think of it like you drive to a parking spot and then you see the parking spot, and from then on the only thing you care about is accurately driving into that parking spot, and the world around you doesn't matter anymore, it's just about going in there. So what we do to achieve this is we model each of the stations or objects we operate with as a grid cell representation, but this time with a much higher resolution of like millimeter range. And then what we do is we drive to the station, We detect it first with a robust template matching algorithm to understand where the station is roughly positioned. And then we use the same technique as before, using the scan matching, but this time with this high resolution model of the station to drive in and out of the station with like millimeter precision, which allows us to also be very flexible, because at the customer side, we can use the stations that we have there, model them, and then be able to drive in and out of them immediately, very accurately.
Localization is great, but it has to be fast and efficient too.
We can provide these updates from the laser scan matching both very fast and very accurately. And this while working on a low energy integrated compute platform. We can achieve this because while using a state-of-the-art nonlinear optimization technique for the front end, so for the laser scan matching part, we have quite a lightweight back end of the state estimation filtering, which is very fast compared to some of the popular frameworks that are used within the industry.
Constant updates keep our arcTech on track. Free navigation means no extra infrastructure, just smart robots localizing fast, accurate, and efficient.